How do you market in a downturn? When a recession comes, how do you change your marketing approach? It really requires two sets of analyses. One, look at the products and services that you're selling. And then number two, look at the consumer segments that you've served to date and how the approaches of those consumer segments to the buying process are changing. So let's start first of all with products. There are really four types of products. Number one, essentials. If you look at canned food sales at the moment, they're through the roof. People fundamentally need food in their pantry. Number two, treats. Treats might include a Haagen-Dazs ice cream. You can't go to the restaurant, so you curl up on your sofa with a tub of Haagen-Dazs. Or you're watching a Netflix movie. Perhaps previously you didn't have Netflix in your home, you were out every evening. So those are treats, affordable treats. Third group of products and services are postponables. You have your existing car, you were thinking about buying a new car, but now all bets are off. You're not sure where your finances are going to be, so you're postponing that purchase. And then the fourth category of goods and services are expendables. Probably and sadly, cruises fall into this category more than any other that one can think of. That's simply off the table at the moment for most consumers. And certainly the cruise ships aren't leaving port anyway. So those are the four types of products. Now what about the four types of consumers? Facing a recession, facing a downturn, you have, first of all, one group of consumers who we call slam-on-the-brakes consumers. They are completely shell-shocked by the situation. They are basically spending nothing other than what they need for essential living purposes. Number two is a category we call pained but patient. These are consumers who are feeling financially a lot worse off. Maybe they've seen their 401k balances go down, and they're nevertheless resilient enough to believe that in the long run things are going to turn around. But in the short run, they're going to be very much more frugal in their expenditures than they have been. A third group of consumers are what we would call the comfortably well-off. These people may have been financially hurt by the downturn, but they're sufficiently well-resourced that with a little bit of pullback in terms of luxury items and postponable purchases, they're nevertheless going to continue with their lifestyle pretty much as before, but perhaps with less obvious ostentation in terms of consumption. In other words, you're not going to go and show off to your neighbor who's just been laid off that you can afford to buy a new Cadillac Escalade. And then finally, the fourth group would be what we call the live-for-today consumers. Normally, the live-for-today consumers are younger people who aren't saving very much. They're spending pretty much against everything they earn. But interestingly, in this particular environment that we're in, with the lockdown in place, they're actually not able to go out and indulge themselves every evening as they normally would. And so what are they doing? They're actually buying more home entertainment equipment. They're buying online movie subscriptions. They're buying workout equipment for home use. In other words, they're trying to replicate their lifestyle as best they can in the context of a much more confined environment. And what you have to do is determine, first of all, what's the mix of current consumers that you had before this downturn, and knowing that, how is their behavior as consumer segments changing in response to the downturn, given the type of product or service that you're selling? So you've got to put together a matrix, if you like, of the four consumer segments against the four types of products and services, and determine from that what your marketing mix is going to look like, because that's going to depend on which segments in this 4x4 chart you're going to be targeting in order to make your revenues and profits in the downturn environment.